Beth Wolverton, and today I will be doing a teaching project on how parents can make hand washing fun for their children. Many times they don't want to take the time out to wash their hands. They're too busy playing, too busy, you know, just doing other things. They don't want to take time out to, you know, get all the germs off their hands right before they eat or things like that. So, how many of y'all have kids? Okay. Do they always want to wash their hands?
Never.
Never?
Never.
Yeah. Mine either. Well, do they even know what germs are? Have they ever said, you know, do they understand? Yeah, do they understand what can be, you know, on their...
No, I have a little boy, so he doesn't.
They know, they just don't care.
Like on the PowerPoint, you know, they don't like it. Things that touch their hands, they don't realize things are actually, you know, everywhere on their hands. Okay, before we get too far, I'm going to go ahead and give y'all everything you will need. Okay? There's a pretest in this packet. And after I hand it out to everybody, I'll get everybody a time to fill it out. The PowerPoint's also in there.
You want us to do a pretest first?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Probably take about, you know, several minutes. Questions to answer. Should you wash your hands with soap and water?
20 seconds.
Okay, that's right. Number two, which place has a lot of germs? Is it grocery cart handle, restroom door handle, or both?
All of them.
Both. Okay, number three, the use of hand sanitizer at school can blank absenteeism. Is it double, reduce, or increase?
Double.
When you miss school, so actually that would be
reduced.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I thought that.
sanitizer, blank, you blow your nose. Is it while you blow your nose, before you blow your nose, or after?
After.
Okay, of course. Okay, these are some fun questions, though, that you can, you know, ask your children. Number six, children who use hand sanitizer products miss blank school. Is it the same amount, less, or more? Seven, restaurant menus are considered to be very clean, old, or germy? Germy, definitely. All those hands. You know, our children don't realize. They think they may be the only one that ever touches anything. They don't understand that people, you know, has handled things before they can. Okay, number eight, blank percent of people do not wash their hands or use hand sanitizer after using a public restroom. Now, this is scary to me. 15%, 85%, or
50%? 15%. 15? Is it 15?
Or 50?
It's
50. 50? So over half people, they don't even wash their hands when they leave the bathroom.
That's
right. Number nine, when you sneeze, you should do what? You should cover your mouth with your hand, you should wipe your nose with your hand, or should you cover your mouth and nose with a tissue? Yes. Number 10, okay, what is the best way to prevent illness? Is it taking medicine, using hand sanitizer and regular hand washing, or staying indoors? Right. Hey, y'all be good on that. All right? Okay, we're fixing to learn some fun ways to get kids excited to wash their hands, okay, and get rid of their nasty germs. Okay. Hand washing really is our best defense against many kinds of bacteria and viruses that causes infection. Children typically don't like to take time out to wash their hands, like we stated before, but there are ways that we can do. So I'm gonna show y'all a few things, you know, that I've done with my own children. There's a picture of a nose blowing nice little green mucusy germs everywhere. Okay, while we do our hand washing, you know, we can just be creative. You know, as my board here states, you know, I've just got it blown up so y'all can see, but it's also on the PowerPoint. You know, they don't understand that they need to wash their hands, you know, after touching their loving pet. You know, they love so much. You know, they think that the pet doesn't have any germs. You know, it's part of our family, but you know, we had germs, so we need to remind them to wash their hands after they play with their pets, after they use the bathroom, after they sneeze, after they blow their nose, after they cough. And then, of course, before, you know, touching a cut or open sore, because germs can be transferred through open skin, you know, playing outside, and before eating, of course. Before we talk about this. This we can go ahead and talk about this. We need to make it fun, you know. We need to make it easy, you know, accessible to the child that can't hardly, you know, reach the handles, you know, to their sink. So we need to, you know, we need to invest in a little stool. You know, you can get it Walmart or, you know, Amazon. Just make it easy for them to reach the sink and encourage them to perform hand hygiene with a stool, and it can be adjusted as, you know, as their age, as they get older. Okay, now, this is a fun little thing that you can buy. That this is another, like, a little fun thing that you can attach to your faucet. It's called a faucet extender, and I found this particular one on Amazon.com.
How much is it?
It's $15.
Ooh.
Yep. But now, you know, there's eBay, of course, and all those places too. But I haven't seen this one at Walmart now, unless it's a brand new item, because I looked the other day and I didn't see it. So. Okay. Now, this is really easy. You can buy soap, take the label off of it, so it'll be clear. And you can just use a, like a pipe cleaner or something, and cushion the Legos inside. Just push them down. And this would be an excellent thing for a little boy, you know. I think, you know, my boys would love this, but I didn't find these little things until they were older. But I still made them surprise soaps that we will talk about later on. And of course, this is the little girl soap. You know, you can do the same thing. Buy something, buy something already made up, take the label off, use a pipe cleaner, something, you know, clean, and just put little figurines, little erasers, little rings that you can buy at Dollar Tree, and make it fun for them, make it interesting, you know. I tell them that when it's all gone, they can have all the toys. Another thing about soap, I'm going to give y'all 12 tips for staying healthy when caring for sick kids, okay? Wash your hands frequently. Try to keep your child in one room as much as possible. Line a bucket or a small trash can with a grocery bag and place, you know, put all your used tissues and all that stuff in there. And they can be encouraged to throw their germs away, you know. Don't let them share glasses or plates or, you know, clean all the surfaces that your child touches. I mean, remote control, any of that stuff, bathroom counters, knobs, door handles. And of course, replace the toothbrush when they're sick. Get as much rest as you can so you can take care of them properly. And don't be afraid to ask for help either. All right, back to the soap. Okay, I've got this in your handouts, how to make kid-made soap. They can help you with this. Everything can be bought at your local Hobby Lobby or your Michael's craft store. Any craft store will have this stuff. It's just glycerin soap that you break off in sections and you melt it. And they have fragrance there. You can pour the fragrance in there. And you have a stirrer. You can just use a spoon. And then microwave it, let it cool. You microwave it, and then you pour it in the molds. You can buy, there's various mold shapes that you can buy. And then when it cools off, you pop them out. Of course, you can put anything in them too, like little surprise soaps. And we need to remind them, you know, wet their hands, soap up for 20 seconds. And 20 seconds for a child, you would just sing row, row, row your boat, like one time through. And happy birthday, that's right.
Twinkle little star, what about
that? That should work, yeah. Just any 15 to 20 minute song that's fun for them to sing, that would be great. And just make them, you know, make as many bubbles as they can. Wash between their fingers, you know, paint their fingers, they're under their fingernails, on the wrists. And then rinse and towel dry. And then I always encourage, you know, to, like number six on the PowerPoint, turn off taps with the towel. Like all your, don't ever touch another handle ever again. And also, I made some certificates for y'all to give your kids. This was real cute. The first one is, I am able to wash my hands after going to the toilet. So you put their name down, you date it, and you give it to them. And you could even frame it, you know, and just put it in the bathroom. And they'll see that, and they'll be proud of themselves. The next slide is, I am able to wash my hands before eating. So just encourage them and praise them and reward them, yeah. That's the biggest thing. All right. This concludes my presentation. So I appreciate y'all, your attention.